Alright, folks. Full Metal Hell here. We're going to do a little flight of the two quads that I unboxed the other day. The MJX 600, which I was able to put back together, kind of glued these things on, and put a little bit of my colored tape for, not just for orientation, you know, it looks kind of cool, not just for orientation as well, but to actually hide where, actually had to heat these arms up a little bit and kind of bend them up where they were deformed from being shipped so horribly with no box and, you know, so forth. You know, please check out my unboxing video. You'll see. It was a big mess. Anyway, got her back together pretty much. And we're going to do this one too. We're going to have a little bit of in-flight video on this one as well, because this does have the built-in camera that I was telling you guys about. Thing is, a little bit windy again. Once again, a little windy. Try to stay around this corner if we can. This one don't have very long flight time so far from what I've noticed, especially if you're recording and you have these prop guards on, which I really do need to take off. I just was doing a little indoor flying with this, and these are actually pretty cool. You can actually hit stuff and bounce off and keep flying. But anyway, I do need to remove these for future. We're going to go ahead and link this one up. We're going to start with this one. And then we're going to fly the MJX. This one does not have an on and off switch, folks. So when you plug it in, the lights come on. One click up, should be linked. That's it. We're going to go ahead and start video. That's picture. Go ahead and start video before we take off. See what the video, really kind of curious to see what the video is going to look like on this one. Wind is blowing around pretty good. See if I can bring it out there and then turn it around. Let the wind kind of blow it back this way, maybe. And that's it. When you're recording, for some reason, folks, this one has absolutely no flight time with the prop guards on. Let's see if I turn the video off. Video is off. Don't know what to say about that. We're going to have to try the bigger battery, maybe on the bottom of this quadcopter. For future flight, see if it lasts longer. Alright, folks, I'm gonna try that again with this thing here. Put another battery in, a little smaller than the stock battery, but wanted you guys to see how this thing flies. I took the prop guards off too. Flies way better with the prop guards off. Oh my goodness, those prop guards are just killing it. And it is breezy today too, folks, so see if we can do a couple of flips. Alright, does the good flips, not the cheater flips, you know, doesn't give all that acceleration. Just stays in one spot pretty good, actually. With the prop guards on, it didn't do quite so well. Alright. Thing's pretty nimble. Must say, I like it, actually. See if we hit a little video, maybe. Probably gonna kill it pretty fast, though. The video does tend to kill this one when you're recording. It does seem to kill it mighty fast. We're gonna go ahead and turn the video off. See if she's blinking. It's blinking yet. Video is off. And the low voltage, you have about 45 seconds, maybe. Maybe with the prop guards off a little longer. I noticed with the prop guards, though, once the low voltage kicked in, you had about 45 seconds. So far, she's still flying with low voltage. Sorry about the sun. That's probably hard to see. Yeah, she's still blinking. All right. Uh-oh. Wind almost took it right there, folks. Ooh-wee. All right, we're going to go ahead and land it. That's about it. Ooh, no. Couldn't bring it back. The wind was killing it. Anyway, hope we got a little video, too. Give you guys an idea of how this thing's flying. As you can see, the wind is blowing. Look at those trees. Yeah, them palm trees. Anyway, just want to give you guys an idea. My door fell off, so I just put a rubber band. Actually, I was going to put a bigger battery on the bottom of this one just to take a little more video for you guys, which I will do. But I figured that'd be cool to just stick a little battery in the bottom. Anyway, we're going to go on to the MJX now. All right, now this thing here, folks, flies really good, actually. Even though it's been beat up from hell and back in shipping, boy, it looked rough when I got it. My God, I was so mad, too. I was really highly upset about that. But, turn that on. All right, turn this on. There we go. All right. This one you actually have to go up and down with the sticks twice, you know, just like any other MJX product. I have this all the way up on this one. Let's go ahead and take off. I am in medium rate as well. It's a really smooth, very nice flying, I want to say quadcopter. It's not, it's a hexacopter. As you can see, the wind is blowing today, though, folks. These six motors spinning, you know, gives it extra oomph, lift, or whatever. It really is blowing, though. I did take a bad day, though, to fly this, though, folks. You can see the water fountain out there is blowing sideways. Just wanted to show you guys that this is a good flyer. This thing flies really, really good. You know, the other day I was out here, you know, there wasn't no wind. I was flying this thing all up through here. I'd come out here, turn it around, bring it back. You know, like I said, I used to do this little circuit here with my 200 QX. Only because it flew so easy to fly, you know. This is a hard little circuit right here to come through here, then back through these trees and not hit yourself. You know, turn around. It's just so windy, I'm not going to go real fast. I just want to, you know, give you guys an idea of what I'm talking about. This thing flies so good, though, folks. Really, MJX did a fantastic job with this one here. They really did do a good job with this one. And even though this one's a little bit beat up, it still flies really, really good. Pretty much straightened out everything. I put all new props, bent the arms back, you know. A couple of them are still not 100% perfect, but pretty close. And I'll tell you what, you know, on a day that's not windy like today, you can very easily do a hands-off hover with this one. And I know from my other MJX products that this controller, the stock controller, has quite a bit of range, at least 150 meters. I mean, we're going to have to test this one at the big AMA field to know for sure, but I'm pretty sure it's the same. This one, too, if it loses contact, it cuts off. We're going to go ahead and land it. All right, I'm going to go ahead and land it. Get her started a little bit. I'm going to cut this off. Two seconds, folks. 2 seconds, it comes. All right, see if we can link it back up. Yep. All right, link back up. Okay, so it's 2 seconds. This one's kind of tricky. When you link it back up, you have to go up with it twice. And for some reason, I always end up taking right off. I don't know why. Not really sure why it does that. Let's try that again. See that? So the second time I went up, it was already linked up. So, not really sure. It's like the initial link up, you have to go up with the stick twice, and then it seems like after that, it's just once. But I always end up hitting the stick up, and it ends up taking off on me. Yeah, I almost hit myself in the face with it. So, don't be standing over top of it when you do that. When you link this one up, kind of be standing back away from it. This one's pretty spunky too. It's got pretty good little pitch forward. I mean, I'll be honest with you. I have the MJX 800. You know, I think it was I think RC Addict said that he liked the 800. You know, over this. I mean, I'll be honest with you. I kind of think I like this one better than the 800. It's a little more controllable, and it's I don't know, he said the other one was faster. I'll be honest with you, I don't see that, really. I think it's pretty close. Ooh. I think this one's really close to the same speed as the MJX 800. And I'll tell you what, this one has way more punch out than the MJX 800. The MJX 800 don't have a lot of up, you know, a lot of punch out. This one has way more punch out, and this one doesn't have that dropping out of the sky problem that the MJX 800 does. The MJX 800 sometimes, you know, if you spin it around too fast or you try to, I don't know why, it'll just drop. Like right there, it'll just boop, drop, and you give it full power up, and it's still not going up. Where this one doesn't have that problem. Maybe it has something to do with it being gear driven and the MJX 800. Being a direct drive, not really sure. Be honest with you, I think I like this one better. Not that I don't like my 800, because I'll tell you what, that 800's a nice flying little FPV camera on it, you know, which I did in one of my other videos. A little bit nicer. I like this one a little bit better. All right, folks, just want to give you an idea of how to crash your quadcopter. I like it. It's a good flying hexacopter, and I highly recommend this one. I just don't recommend buying it from Wow2Buy. Do not buy from them, because boy, when you get it, you're gonna say wow, all right. You know what, folks? I was flying the X600 out here just a few minutes ago, but it was all, you know, it was doing all this up and down, like this, like up and down and up and down, you know, but I'm doing that, you know, manually with the controller, because this one doesn't have that problem. This one actually cuts through the wind better than the 600, actually. The X800, actually, I'll be honest with you, I did not realize this was that good of a flyer. You know, I haven't done a lot of flying outside, you know, in close quarters, just at that big field. I did the FPV thing with this one. You know, actually lifted that camera very easy. But man, you know what? might take that back, what I said earlier about liking the 600 better. I think I do like the 800 better. You know what, too? This one has direct drive. So if you land in the dirt, you know, you crash or whatever, you land in the dirt, you know, you pick it up, blow it off, and you're back flying again. Where the X600, every time you crash, every time, okay, even if you just land somewhere where there's a little bit of sand, the props must blow it up, and it goes right through those little holes and right into the gears every time. I can't tell you how many times I've done clean that thing, those gears. And I'll tell you something else. The landing gear on that thing, if you're not going to use the camera on that quadcopter, hexacopter, I would suggest taking that tall landing gear off. Because every time you land, it tips over. And when it tips over, a lot of times it gets dirt in the gears. And it just, it's a pain in the butt, I'll be honest with you. We're going to do some kind of modification. I'm going to take off, you know, I'm not going to use the camera on that particular hexacopter. So I'm going to go ahead and take the tall landing gear off it. And I'm going to put some kind of cushions, kind of similar to what Frequent Flyer did on the JJRC X1. I'm going to do something similar to that because, you know, not only would it be better landing gear so when you land, it doesn't tip over, but I believe something like that would help to keep the sand out of the gears. Because I'll tell you what, that's a big problem with that particular hexacopter. The teeth are so fine on those gears, all it takes is one little tiny pebble of sand and you're done. You're done. You got to take it apart and clean it and all that stuff again. But I did show you the, you know, little modification how to get to those gears much easier by leaving that particular screw out that I showed you guys earlier. But you know what? Man, this little guy here is nice, man. This little guy. And something else. I'm not flying it with the Dromina battery right now. So as you can see, when I do flips, it kind of loses altitude. Does that little dropping thing that I was talking about earlier. Well, I'll tell you what, guys, if you put that big 850 milliamp Dromina battery, which happens to fit right in there, slides right in there. If you put that battery in there, for some reason, the extra milliamps, and maybe just the quality of the battery, allows it to not do that dropping thing. You can actually do flips and recover much easier with that battery for some reason. It's like the extra weight of the battery doesn't seem to matter. It's the milliamps that it has, the power, makes up for it. This is just a stock battery because this is all I had charged right this particular second, but it does fly better with the Dromina battery, and it flies a really long time with that big battery too, by the way. So if you guys get a chance, pick you up some of those Dromina one cell 850 milliamp batteries because they are really, really good, even for this particular hexacopter. She's blinking, so I'm going to go ahead and cut it off. Just want to show you guys that, man. You know what? This thing here is really sweet, man. I must say, I really like this hexacopter, man. The 800 might be better than the 600, guys. The 600 flies really smooth, but it's really floaty. It's like it's so big and it's kind of underpowered in comparison to this one. Though it does seem to have pretty good punch out, you know, maybe even more so than this one. But this one has a little more forward pitch speed. All right, folks. Full Metal Heli. We're in the lab, too, real quickly with the MJX X600. I just want to show you guys something, you know. This is the same problem I have with the MJX 400, you know. Every time you land, like, and some sand blows up, it goes right through these little things right here and gets right into your gears. And these are some really fine-cut teeth. The pitch on these teeth are really fine, so any little piece of sand or dirt that gets in there, you have problems. The gears start locking up. That's what I didn't like about my MJX 400 also, besides the way it flew. So, you know, what I ended up doing was I ended up closing all these little holes off. I ended up painting these little pieces here, and it kept a lot of dirt. It actually worked pretty good, but something I noticed, okay, when you go to take these screws off, there's three screws. There's one, two, and three. And you would think this whole little bottom piece would pull off. Well, there's a screw up under here that holds this whole piece onto. And the only way to get to that screw is by taking this motor cap. You got to take this screw off and at least loosen this one, is what I do. Pop this up and move it to the side so you can see your motor. Well, down inside there, right down in here, I don't know if you guys can see it, there's a screw in there. And that screw's got to come out because that's what holds this piece on, as well as these three screws around the outside. So, you know, if you want to pull this off every time to clean your gears and pull this off every time to clean your gears, then go ahead and put this screw back in. But I'll tell you what I learned from my other quadcopter, the MJX 400, is that this screw, yeah, you don't need that screw anymore. The one that goes down in there, bam, it goes right to here, yeah, and it goes through here. The only way to get to it is through here. So, you know, that's a pain in the butt to have to open this cap up to get to this screw. And the only way to do that is to pull this whole piece off. So, you know what? The quick and easy solution for that is don't put that screw back in. Okay? That's the easy solution for that one, folks. Here's all I had to do was pull out these three screws, and this piece here will pop right off. Then I can clean my gears without having to go through all this. Anyway, just a little trick I wanted to pass on to you guys. You know, makes it much easier. And I'll be honest with you, when you have these three screws tightened up, these three here, this piece is not going nowhere. Going to you guys. And what I do is to clean my gears is I go ahead and get like an old toothbrush, go ahead and knock out a lot of the dirt the best you can. Then what I do is I'll spin it. I'll hold it here and I'll spin it around. And if there's a piece of dirt in here somewhere, you'll feel it. It'll stop. It'll go tick. And then you look and you'll be able to see it. And just take like a little poker or something sharp and just go in there and pop it out. You know, that's all you gotta do. And that's it, basically. Just want to give you guys my little trick I wanted to pass on to you guys. Make it much easier to work on this quadcopter. Because cleaning gears for some reason with these MJXs is an endless battle. Unless you do, like I said, what I did on the MJX 400. What I did to it, actually, I just painted these. You know, it looks ugly. I ain't gonna lie. It sure does look ugly. But, you know, it sure did keep all the dirt out, too. And it was kind of cool for orientation. But, you know, you could probably do something better than this. This was just like some quick spray paint. Actually, no, you know what? I take that back. I had shoe glued these first, like hot glued them, the holes. That's why they look so bad. And then I figured out, well, I could just paint them. And then I painted over top of the shoe glue. That's why they look so rough. Honestly, you could probably use maybe a clear, like a polyurethane maybe or something. I don't know. We'll see in the future. Some future mod ideas. But be honest with you, when this landed in sand, the dirt no longer got inside my gears, you know, made a big difference. And these here are missing those screws I was talking about. You can see, you know, you can pull it down a little bit, you see that? But these three screws do a fine job holding this piece on. It's not going anywhere. You don't need that extra little screw in there. Okay. Anyway, hope you like my little mod and just want to keep you guys informed on the latest little tricks and tips. Peace out. Oh, and as far as you know, an old toothbrush, you know, it just works fantastic for not only for cleaning the gears, but for cleaning the quadcopter itself. You know, if you get sand up under these props or whatever, you know, it's just a great little tool. You know, you get it down inside your little on and off switch. You know, it's good for that. You know, it's just a good little tool for cleaning your quadcopters. And if you're the mighty Thor, you know, you don't have to use your old toothbrush. You can just use your good toothbrush. Because I think he just got all his teeth pulled out. Just playing. Sorry. Yeah, I'm sure this toothbrush is, like, really aggravating you right now. But anyway, just wanted to give you a little tip on how to use your toothbrush.